Oh, hello people. I wasn't planning to stream today. Basically it's Christmas Day. So Merry Christmas everybody. I hope you've had or are having a wonderful time with your family and your loved ones and the people you care about. Here it's 20 to 12, 20 to midnight. So my wife is in bed, my kids are in bed. And it's just me. I was watching Kim Justice's stream, and near the end of the stream there was some news which kind of surprised me. And yeah, George Michael, the singer, who did hits such as Freedom, Faith, Last Christmas, I Gave You My Heart, but the very next day he gave it away. He was part of Band Aid. He was part of Wham, Wake Me Up Before You Go Go. You know, that kind of thing. He Club Tropicana. He did a multitude of classic tracks. He is a legend in the music industry, or was a legend. Unfortunately, he passed away tonight. He passed away. And yeah, it's really weird. He's been part of the background music of my life for forever. And he's very important to me, because he links in with my life in a way. George Michael actually helped me marry my wife. Yeah, in a roundabout way. See, the thing is, we were on holiday, and we're going to see my wife's family. She was my girlfriend at the time. And we were in Singapore. It was the middle of July, and it was 34 degree heat. And we went to this little, I've forgotten where it was, but there's this programmable fountain in one of the tourist centers. And this programmable fountain, you could put a music track in, and you could also put a request. So I put in a request to my wife. I've forgotten what the song was I wanted, but the computer glitched. So in the middle of July, in 35 degree heat, my request was played out to Last Christmas by George Michael. So there's just my wife and I under this fountain with the request streaming via LED lights through the water of it, and yeah, Last Christmas starts playing and I feel like a complete twat, and my wife found it hilarious, and it helped us get closer, and it helped get us together, and well, we're married now, and we've been together for I don't know how many years now. 12 years. Married for 8. Yeah, it's a long time. And I like to think that George Michael helped that along the way somewhat. With his music. Yeah, so hearing that he passed away, especially on Christmas Day, was a bit weird. And I didn't know how to react, and I didn't know what to do, and I'm not here really doing anything anyway. In fact, I was just getting some SD cards ready to hook up to the Wii U so that I could record footage for the Wii U. But hey, things change. We got to go with the flow. I'm still adapting that SD card as we speak. It's transferring data. but I figured, well, let's talk about things. Let's see things through. See if anybody else has got any interesting stories about George Michael or how he affected their life. And in the meantime, play some fucking video games. You know, like we're supposed to do. And enjoy ourselves and think about the happy times. So while I have no idea what I'm going to play, I'm pretty sure it's going to be something upbeat. So let's have a little gander, a little look, see what we can find here. Okay, so should we do something Christmassy? Christmassy? Oh, shall we do? Let me see. Okay, let's get it started, because there's nobody actually watching this right now, I'm pretty sure. Oh, there is somebody watching. Okay, that's a nice surprise. Hello, whoever you may be. I can't tell who you are at this point, but thank you for joining me and sharing a bit of your Christmas Day with me. I really appreciate that. Thank you for your time. And as I said, let's play some fucking video games, eh? Okay. I don't know why I turned Australian. I apologise. I love my Australian cousins, but for some reason, I just got to slip it out every now and again. And I can't understand it why. And I'm not even that good as an Australian. I'm a Brit. But I digress. What are we going to play? Any suggestions from the guys in the chat? Anybody? Anything? Any ideas at all? Because I ain't got a bloody clue. This is a complete impromptu stream. I did not expect to be streaming tonight. I've got nothing ready. The place is a mess. But the Christmas tree's on, as you can see over my shoulder. And on the reflection in the TV, which is here somewhere. Yeah, so the Christmas lights are still on. And you know what? I am going to play something I haven't played in ages, but it never fails to make me happy. So let me just get this set up. Never fails. It's a classic. Absolute classic. What it is, you will find out shortly. Let me just find it in the list here. There it is. Let's hope it works, eh? As I say, it's been a while. I don't know whether you can hear me, whether you can hear the game. I haven't got a Scooby-Doo. But the game is the almighty, amazing, wondrous, fan-dabby-frickin'-dozy Rainbow Islands. So wait one second, my controller isn't showing up, so let me just amend that. One moment. Okay, just getting the controller showing up so that you can see my inputs. That should do it. Yeah. Okay, now I don't know why the YouTube chat is showing up quite like that. It should be showing up as it normally does. So let's do a little tweak there. As I say, this is completely impromptu, so I set none of this up beforehand. I normally have this all done by the time I start streaming, but today just isn't one of them days. Okay, you know what? We'll skip putting the chat on. We'll leave the chat off the video on this one. Okay, I think we're just about good to go. Can you see the game though? No, you can't. Now you can. Let's get this all lined up so you can see the full screen. Yeah. Okay. Let's play something. Let's get happy. Let's set some controls. Okay. Can we hear audio, people? Yes, we can. So the trick with this game is not only do you have to traverse your way up to the top of the area, but you have to get the enemies to die in certain positions. And when they do, they drop gems, and if you get gems in the order of the rainbow, then you get to bonus rounds and hidden areas, and get the proper ending of the game. But it's very, very difficult to do so. Yeah, for example, I've only got 3 gems right now. Give me the food, give me the food, yum, 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 yum. You get power-ups that make things easier for you, like double rainbows, faster rainbows. And the rainbows can be manipulated in different ways as well. So you can run across them like bridges. You can jump on them to destroy enemies below you. Or if you hold the jump button, you can actually die miserably. You can actually jump off them for a certain amount of time before they weaken and just drop off. This game notoriously got sued for being remarkably similar in music to Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Completely unintentional, of course, with a game all about frickin' rainbows. To protect themselves from future lawsuits, they did change the music in later revisions, but this original version, it's all intact, along with some of the home conversions, like the Amiga version, still has the Somewhere Over the Rainbow track. And in my opinion, it's how the game's intended to play, so you should always play this version. I'm struggling to get those, the red one. I need to get a red diamond. Hey Gabe, how's it going? Whee! Merry Christmas, Gabe. Hope you're having a good one, or have had a good one, depending on where in the world you are. Ah! Death by controller malfunction. No! Okay, it seems like I got a sticky jump button. Oh yeah, one up. Still haven't got the red key though. The red diamond. This should do it. Boom. There we go, so I've completed my rainbow. Although I didn't do it in sequential order, so I won't get the true ending. But I will get the bonus round if I can make it through. Hey Georgia, how's it going? I hope you've had a Merry Christmas, or are in the middle of having a Merry Christmas, or whatever holiday you celebrate. Awesome. Ah. Okay, so here's the boss. I'm gonna die. Lame. That's gonna make my life way more difficult. As you can see, because I didn't get the stars in order, the bonus room. Yeah, RIP George, definitely. What a shocker. Couldn't believe it. Couldn't believe it. This year's been rotten for celebrities. It's, yeah, as I said at the top of the show, George Michael has a very special place for me. He actually helped my wife and I get together, so I got a lot to thank him for, really. I did the whole story earlier in the year, earlier in the stream, but yeah, David Bowie, that was a heartbreaker, Bowie. Yeah, Alan Rickman, yeah, I loved him in Die Hard. I've got to say, I'm not a Harry Potter fan, but I loved him in Die Hard. And he's a very good comedic actor. I loved him in Dogma as well, which is a very underrated movie. There's just been so many. And Justin Bieber wasn't one of them. I mean, how unlucky can you get? I'm going to die so bad. Yep. Prince, yeah, another one. That was a devastator. Right, we're going to continue this game and carry on. That's more like it. One more. Nah. Why couldn't I do that the first time? Yeah, Victoria Wood. Yeah, she passed this year. She was a very good comedian. She's one of the few truly, truly funny comedians from the 90s. She was way up there. She's right up there with... well, I can't think of anybody else offhand British. Apart from Caroline Burke, is it? Caroline Burke, who was in Harry Enfield and Chums. She made me laugh. She makes me laugh. Excuse me. Yeah, I'm a bit under the weather, which is why I haven't been doing many streams and things lately. I've been a bit poorly for the past month, but today is just a fuck it day. You hear about George, and it was like, wow, okay, I just want to chill out and relax and just celebrate what he's done for the music industry and what his music did for me personally, and just shoot the breeze with people for a while, you know? My major regret, George Michael was a bit of a tortured soul in his last years, and it's just so sad that he seemed to find his footing over the last year or two, with his Symphonica album, doing the tours and everything. He seemed to really be getting his life back on track, and now it's just been cut from him. It's heartbreaking, you know? He went through all that emotional turmoil when his mum passed away. He's just getting back on his feet, and then, yeah, well, the world fucked him. Yeah, it's been a strange old year, and I won't be sorry to see the back of it, to be perfectly honest. I mean, there were some good moments in 2016, but, you know, it was my son's first birthday and his second Christmas, so there's magical times too, but in between Brexit, Donald Trump, celebrity deaths on a weekly basis, it feels, it just seems so lopsided towards death, destruction, carnage and misery, that I can't wait to see the back of the year. Which is exactly why we need to play games like this, Rainbow Islands. Because this game, deep down, makes you feel happy. You play this for any length of time, and it just heals your soul a little bit. I don't think it's possible to be really sad when you play this game. I think you can reflect on things gone by, but you can't be remorseful or sorrowful. You can tell this game was made with love, and it shines in every aspect of it. In later levels you do, when you get to the horror themes. Oh, and the bosses, yeah, the bosses are pricks. One more rainbow would have got him. Shit. I am rusty at this. No! Okay, let's stop being clever. Let's just stick and move. Go. and now it's Monster World. Or, yeah, I think it's called Monster World. Monster Island, yeah. This is the one that drives me insane. Although those are the cutest Frankensteins you ever did see. The douchebags. Ah. Let's go again. Let's get the traders. Oh, I'm just gonna find my window to get up there safely. They're all getting pissed with me. That's my window. You know what? I'm not even thinking about the gems at this point. It's just survival, and I'm not even doing that very well. Bollocks. Oh no, don't make me fall all the way down. Son of a... Damn. Boink. Back to where I was. And there's the goal. Okay, we're through. Come get me. Yeah. Fuck! Oh man, I forgot about the fireballs. Damn it. Alright, try that again. And the fireballs actually damage your rainbows, so you can't just stack them up like you normally do. Dracula, come get me. Thank you. I'll take that gem. Take that one too. We're going to ignore that guy because he's an asshole. Okay. Yes, yes. No, get me up there. Ah. For a kid's game, it's hard as nails. It's one of the toughest platformers I ever remember. Especially with the gem mechanic. And the fact that the time limits are so stringent. I mean, what you haven't seen in my game, because I keep trying to move up quick enough, is that you are timed. If you're too slow, then the water level raises up from beneath and fucks with you. You drown. Unfortunately, I'm not living long enough to demonstrate that at this point. Boom! Man. This is my all or nothing. If I miss this, I go back to section one of this level. Wow. Let's try again. Oh no, I do start from the same area. That's good. That gives me a bit of reprieve. Still not enough of one for my liking, but... No! Bad timing. No! This is going to be where I just stumble. This is going to be the stumbling block. I hate Monster Island. Okay. Goal! Woo! It's a Christmas miracle. Of course, I'm never going to make it past this level. Well, there's the green onion, but I can't get it safely. Green, so I just need red now. Whoa, that was risky. This is risky too, but totally worth. Yay! Complete the rainbow. No! I'm leaning in. I'm in full concentration mode. You notice the commentary is drying up. I am focusing as if my life depended on it. Which, well, the game life does. No, you don't. Come on, get me there. Get me there. Yes! Okay. And right out the gate. Danger at every turn. Come on, come down. No, it's not gonna. Thank you. No! I wanted to go under and jump up. Damn. Can we get to the next world? Can we get to the next island? If I remember rightly, the boss in this island is a piece of piss. It's just getting to him that's hard. I might be misremembering that, though, because it has been several years. And I mean several years. We're talking 92, possibly? I want to say 92. That may not be entirely right, but it feels about right when I say it, so I'm saying it. No! What a game this is. It's still fun to play. It really is fantastic. How the hell am I gonna do this? Piss off. Piss off. Piss off. Piss off. 2016 of a fucking video game enemy. Oh! R.I.P. Alex, yeah, can't believe it myself. At first I thought it was a hoax, but now I checked BBC and it's up there, man. And then Ricky Gervais started tweeting it, and it's just, what a shitstorm. Such a shame. As I was just saying before in the stream, just when the guy was getting his life back together, I mean, his life was in tatters after his mum died, and he went off the rails a little bit, and he was just settling in. He was thankful for his life. He started doing these live tours with these big symphonic orchestras, and he was really kicking ass. And then he's gone. And he didn't draw in a drug-fueled binge like a lot of people believed he would. He just passed away. Probably cardiac arrest or something like that. Yeah, it's a real shame. And on Christmas Day, when he's famous for singing Last Christmas, it's heartbreaking. It really is. This year's been rough for celebrity passings. Some that have been very special to me have passed. Bowie, for example, was a killer. Lemmy. And I was gutted about Lemmy, because Lemmy pretty much personifies the whole rock and roll lifestyle. That guy fucking lived it, man. He was a true, true rock and roller. And him being lost was a big shock and a big heartbreak as well. He was like the Lynyrd Skynyrd track, free as a bird, that guy. And everyone loved him for it. And as I remembered rightly, that boss was a piece of piss. I can't remember the next island. Oh, Toy Island. You know? Oh, thank you. Thank you, Alexa. Thanks for the sub. Sorry, Alex. Why did I say Alexa? I don't know. It's been one of those days. It's been a busy one for me today. Over here, it's 12 minutes past midnight here in the UK. So, of course, our Christmas is now over. And I was woken up at 7:30 by two very excitable children. My kids, one of them's 5 and one of them's 15 months. So, they were really pumped for Christmas. And we had a wonderful day, and everything seemed perfect. No squabbles, no arguments, nothing. It was just lovely. The kids were happy to receive all the gifts they had. And in fact, they've got so many. I don't know if you can see on camera, but... let's see, there we go. They've got so many gifts that we're going to have to give more out tomorrow. And maybe up until the new year. So it seemed perfect. It seemed like the perfect Christmas. And then, just at the end, George passed away. But you can say he was only 53, but I tell you what, he did a lot more in those 53 years than most of us would in 100. The guy lived to the fullest, you know. He was a celebrity in the 80s and in the coke fueled 80s, where it was nothing but drinking, partying, drugs, living the life at Club Tropicana. And then becoming open about his sexuality. And he's very, very adventurous in that regard. And he was free. And he was out there. And he said, this is what I am. This is who I am. This is what I like to do. And if you've got a problem with that, then that's your problem. It's not mine. And that really influenced a lot of people I know. I know of one guy in particular who I work with who will be devastated at the loss of George Michael, for that very reason. He was an inspiration and an idol to one of my workmates. And if you're a music fan, you know, not only did he have his own hits, but he wrote hits for other people. There was one song I remember quite vividly, and it was just after George Michael's mum had passed away. And I've forgotten who the singer was, but it was a fairly big hit here in the UK. And George Michael sang a verse in this song for this other guy. I think his name was Toby Burke, but I'm not entirely sure. I might have misremembered that. But the song was called Waltz Away Dreaming. And it was all about the story of this guy who lost his wife. And he'd waltz away, searching his days away, searching for the woman he loved. And then George Michael added his touch to it to talk about his mum. And yeah, it was a beautiful, heart-wrenching song. Like, true writing masterclass. It really made you feel every word that was sung. And it was truly beautiful. And George Michael could go everything from pop to real sentiment in a heartbeat. He was so talented at stuff like that. These platforms are getting tougher. Well, you hear the music sped up that time. I nearly got to the end of the time limit, which is the first time in this playthrough. Damn! I apologise for the cough. As I say, I've not been well, but this is an impromptu stream just for the hell of it. Just to chat, talk about George Michael, talk about the year that's gone past, talk about games, talk about life, just talk, really. Talk about chocolate covered peanut M&Ms, yum yum. Thank you. Anyway, I hope you guys were fed well for Christmas. And I hope you got a lot of wonderful stuff. And I hope you managed to spend it with the people you love. And I hope you appreciated every minute you spent with each other. Fuck! This is starting to piss me off. And I didn't think it was possible to get pissed off at this game, because it's just so generally jolly. But falling like that will definitely do it. That's going to sorely affect my time. Ah, it's the bounce off the rainbow. Are we going to make it? There's only so many tries you can do at this game before you want to say fuck this and then move on to the next thing. And it's getting awfully close to the fuck this. If I hit those balls a couple of more times, I'm going to be right there. So guys, what was your favourite George Michael track? Have you got a favourite song of his? Oh, I've dug myself into a corner there. Fuck! Come on. Well, at least I made progress. Made it through. Bollocks. Double bollocks. Triple bollocks. Ooh. If I can't even get off the ground, how bad is this level gonna be? Boom! In concentration mode again. Fuck! I keep getting so close. No. Being careful. No, 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 no. Fuck you, boxing glove. Fuck you, spinning joker. Ah! Right, okay. Double rainbow. No! Yeah, my mind's not fully in it. I'm still thinking about, you know, holy shit, what a bastard of a year this has been, really. When you think about it.
The whole world's gone to hell in a handbasket. And not only with the celebrities, but Trump. I would never trust anybody to run the country that's named after a fart. And I would say, why worry? Because I don't live in America, but I've got Brexit. And that's just as bad. And it's just as shameful and sorrowful and anger-inducing and depressing. It's like, holy shit, why are people choosing these xenophobic kind of fucked up policies to be governed under? Why do people live in fear about the odds of what may happen in future that are so infinitesimally small odds of actually happening, there's no point worrying about. I mean, you look at Afghanistan, for example. Afghanistan has had terrorism since the 80s. We've always been under attack and against Israeli forces. You look at the IRA. I mean, these are things that we dealt with on a daily basis in the UK. Especially the IRA, the Troubles in Ireland, are something you heard on the news daily. You really did. And we managed to cope. We sat down with their leaders, we talked things out, we arranged a ceasefire, we got things done. Eventually. It wasn't a quick thing, but, you know, people weren't afraid like they are now. Like they are with terrorism, with Al-Qaeda. We just accepted it as part of life and we moved on. And we said, well, treat each day as if it was your last, because it could be. That's whether you're under terrorist threat or not. Life is very short and very valuable. Why waste it on fear and just let people like our leaders currently control what we have to do, say, think? And the countries are getting more selfish, people are getting more selfish, and our policies and our government are reflecting that, and it's really, really sad. And my performance in this game is really, really sad. I'm fucking sucking. Bollocks. Damn. Yeah, get my ass kicked. One last try. Ready? Yeah! Piss off, you bastard. Nah. Caught in the cross draft. Oh shit. That ain't good. I'm dead. Bam 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 ba dim bam. Boom. Game over. But it's a fun game. And it certainly took the edge off what I'm sure a lot of us are feeling right now.
let's update the chat to reflect what I want to do. Okay. So what's going to be next? Do we play another arcade game? I've been doing a lot of beat-em-ups lately. I don't know what it is about beat-em-ups recently, but I've been hammering them. I mean, playing a lot of them. A lot. Is it worth playing another one? I'm trying to think of which ones I haven't covered already. I know, while I'm figuring it out, for some of you, there may be a small ad break. I'm just trying to figure out what game to play, so I'm going to play an ad, and hopefully by the time you come back, I'll have it all sorted out. So what am I going to do? For those, the rest of you that are in here, I haven't even looked. I don't know if anybody's watching at this point, but if you are, hello, and thank you for spending a bit of time with me on this Christmas weekend. I really appreciate the time, and I really appreciate the likes and the subscribes and the chill outs and the general awesomeness that you guys bring into my life. So thank you. Thank you very much. Now let's play something cool. You know what? This is kind of a tie-in to today. Not the George Michael thing, but earlier today, in the early hours of the morning, a new trailer went out for the new Alien movie, Prometheus 2, Alien Covenant. So, should we celebrate that as well? Should we do a homage to Alien? How does that sound? Well, even if it sounds shit, that's what I'm going to do anyway. Because I want to play another beat-em-up, and I want to play Alien versus Predator, which loosely ties in to the general theme of things tonight. As in, there are no themes, it's basically I'm winging it. And that's how we roll today. So let's set up some keys. It's a fresh build of MAME, so it's all up to date. I don't need to worry about other players joining me because I am going to be on my lonesome, and I am going to be doing a one credit run. Now, by one credit run, don't expect me to beat the entire game. What I mean by one credit run is see how far I can get with only using one credit. So here we go. This is a great game, by the way, if you haven't played it. I was gutted that it never got a home release. I was hoping it would come out on Sega Saturn, but never did. Okay. It's got a bit of warrior pred. Round one. You got the super magazine, it's time to shoot him down. It's a trap. Oh, I lost my staff. Yeah, there we go. That'll do. That'll do. No, I'm not Arnold Schwarzenegger, not at all. Mr. Moving Mouthpiece. Carnage is intense. Look at the amount of sprites on screen at once. This really showed off what the CPS2 hardware could really do. Hey, Bobby. Yeah, I love this game too. Mindless alien killing. In fact, most of the Alien vs Predator games, arcade or not, have been really, really good. The only downside was the Super Nintendo one, which wasn't very good. But all of the other ones, you know, PC. Oh yeah, there is a definite combo system in this game as well. There's a juggling system. So if you get the sides just right, you can juggle. I'm nowhere near experienced enough to know all of the combos, but I do understand the basic principle of this game. Again? Give the other controller a try. Boom. Okay, I'm in trouble. Yep, I'm dead. Ooh, this is gonna be tough. I'm gonna have to start using my gun. Okay. Dead humans. Ow, come on. Okay, so I can get nowhere on one credit. Let's do two. That's not enough of the game to show, really. In my opinion, I need more. Piss off. Man, there goes another life. That's another credit gone already. Alright, fuck it. We're plowing more credits in. I refuse to be beaten on the first level. Or second level then. Congratulations, our winner is you. We go. Yeah, I've always wanted a main cabinet, but the problem is I don't have the space, the money, or the inclination to build one. Otherwise I'd be right there. But for now, for the arcade stuff, I just beam most things over to the TV. I've got a 55 inch Ultra HD TV, so I just beam everything across to that, which works pretty well for an arcade. You just hook up an Xbox controller and away you go. It's not quite arcade stick, but it's versatile and it works. So yeah, it does me well. Oh yeah, you'd have to have a room of doom. What I love about this game is the little details, like the way the armor rotates as he walks backwards and forwards. It rotates in a very realistic manner. Okay. Nah. One of the face huggers is out. I'll overheat just to get rid of it. Okay, next level. The hunt must continue. This way to get this shit in the box. And then up here to get this shit. Yeah, you stop fighting the alien horde just to grab a quick salad. Absolutely, everybody does that. Nades, we got points, and we have an alien. I'm not one of you guys again. Yeah, this is the loss of another life. Let's swap to the other predator. Let's see if this one fares any better for me. I can't get my combos to set up properly. I was juggling before, but I've lost my mojo, lost my rhythm. And that was not cool. Get off of me! Get off me, bro! I want to eat that delicious, freshly laden meat. Well, I'm not doing much better with that. Let's try the human characters. Major Schaefer. Now, the human characters feel weak by comparison. Okay, the gun hit charges up a lot quicker, but... yeah, it just doesn't feel right. There we go. Oh, it's Egg City. Wow. Two shots of his gun there. Alien Queen.
It's a killer queen.
Man, you can't get close to the bitch. Maybe someone a little quicker might be better. Well, a gun's surprisingly damaging. Okay, maybe Kurosawa is the one to go for. I don't believe it!
Secrets.
That gun is ridiculous. Hello, Lord Francio. What a welcome, lovely introduction you gave yourself there. Oh, you're a charming chap, Lord Francio. I have no idea who Jackie Sardou is. I don't really care either. Good to know that they let you out for a special day. Looking like Bibix. Who the fuck is Bibix? Ah, oh, good to know, Lord Francio, that there are still assholes like you in the world. No wonder why Trump's president now, because the retarded are able to vote. That's the level done. I'll be verse forever for you. Okay, yeah, I don't know what language you're talking, but your anus scratch you. Well, it seems like you do have a pretty big asshole. Really need help. Yeah, I gathered that from your chat. Although I'm not the kind of guy who can give you that kind of help. Only a registered psychiatrist can do that for you, pal. Taking a ride under a train, well, it's kind of messy for everybody else. Yeah, you don't want to take a ride under a train. Break the control box. I do like memes. Memes are awesome. Especially dank memes. Nah, didn't quite do it. No bonus. Bollocks. That boy. Do a dab. I'm playing right now, Francio. I tell you right now, if you want to donate, I will do a dab for you. How about that? Or alternatively, you can wait till the next level. And then I'll dab you.
Terrible! Something's happened back there.
Dab like Hitler. Now that's more of a Sieg Heil more than a dab. The 1940 dab. Well, I haven't quite got the tash for it. You need the moustache if you're going to do it right. You also need a very big oven. I'm gonna lose another life. Shit. You can tell this game was never designed for the home market. Jesus. You can do it in a child garden. That's a totem pole dab. You know, because you got wood. What the fuck? This predator didn't get the memo. And he also reminds me a lot of Rolento in Final Fight. Feck off. That's ridiculous. Nah, well, a little bit of French, Lord Francio. A little bit. Go on, speak French. I don't know what you want me to say. La merde de tête. Oh, thanks for the sub, whoever that is. I can't really see on my screen. Ah, croissant. Ah, j'adore la France. Or how about fish? Poisson. Croissant and poisson. Never really liked French that much. There are cousins here in the UK, so they're only a sea away. So it's much like Spanish in America. Everybody learns French for the most part at school. It's supposed to open up trade and things, but never did. I've only used French in France. You can teach me. Teach me the way, oh mighty Lord Francio. While I look at that parasite infested weird fucking predator. Round 7. Well, this went from a 1 credit, see how far I can get someone. Not quite. The Marcherie bid, yes. Yes, Alien vs. Predator, the arcade version. Just basically... Son of a bitch! Right, pick up a smart gun for now. Get off me! Yeah, I am rusty at this. Very, very rusty. And today's stream, I didn't prep or anything. I just thought, fuck it, let's go and just play. So, yeah. Chances are I am going to suck at most of these games. But it doesn't really matter. Because I just want to chill out and play. So... I'm not going for a speed run, not getting anything daft like that, not doing a one credit clear, just playing. You're a funny guy, Lord Francio. Yeah. Right, let's go for Kurosawa again. Maybe this is the kitchen. This is set in the future. Yeah, I'm really sure that punching a acid dripping fucking alien in the face is just gonna be, yeah, really useful. That's really gonna work. Oh, Seabream, lovely. You don't actually see Seabream that often in video games. It's usually a bit of COD. And we all know COD sucks. Oh yeah, made a throw. Okay, I'm gonna get my ass handed to me now though, of course. Steamrolled. Fuck off! Ah, there we go. Man. This is where you can tell the game artificially extends its difficulty just to get you to plow in those last couple of coins. Yes, she sure is getting gangbanged. But she's got the bigger gun. Had it. Just die. That'll do. Oh no, it's a static door. Better jump away and hide. Lord Francio, no, I'm not American or gay, no. No, I'm English, I'm British. No, I'm not gay, I'm married with kids. Out. Getting married is no congratulations. Staying married is the hard bit. Getting married's easy. Excuse me. Oh, you see the slowdown there? And that amazing mid-air throw. Alien orgy, soldier orgy, it's just all in all our love fest this game. Much like the chat tonight, really. Season of goodwill, everyone loving each other. Ow. Those are some mighty big guns. So let's give him a big fist. Nice to talk to you too, Mr. Lord Francio. However weird it may have been. Jesus. Anyway. Miss you a Merry Christmas. Even though you treated me like shit when you walked in. Have a good one. Yeah, and a happy new year to you too. Take care, Lord Francio. And in the meantime, I have no idea how much more of this game there is left. So I might as well play it to the end now. We had a few minor chat interruptions, we had a disconnect, but we're going to carry on regardless. Okay. I am literally just hammering buttons at this point. There's too many enemies to try and tactically hit them. I'm just gonna hammer the button and whatever sticks, sticks. That's gotta hurt. Why fight against us? You're one of us. Give up while you can. Oh, I wouldn't like to get slapped silly with that gun. Let me guess, he's got it. He's got it. Just a couple of grenades. Okay, this is getting ridiculous. Look at how insane this is. Has anyone done a credit count? I have no idea how many credits I've used. So much for the use just one, see how far I get thing. Ooh, slice me, dice me. Look at them health bars. Let's go back to the Predator. Okay. The only thing you haven't thrown at me at this point is the kitchen frickin' sink. And I get the feeling that's coming up next. Get off me. There goes another life. So we'll try the other hunter. You are going to go down. It's just a battle of attrition. How many coins will it cost me to see the end? At this point, if this was an arcade, probably about 20 quid at this rate. I've gone through so many credits. Just as the game wanted me to. There we go, it's dead. Yatta! Get to the escape pod. There we go. The ending, ladies and gentlemen. Kablooey. Then our hunt is over. And I get a shard off the predator's little weapon there. See you soon. That's a bit ominous. Against the prospect that aliens will spread over North America with lightning speed, all of them were miraculously annihilated due to the explosion of a nuclear fusion furnace caused by the crash of the spaceship. But it is very likely that the conglomerate... Not enough time to read that out loud. Weyland-Yutani, yada 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 yada. And that was Alien vs. Predator, a fantastic arcade game, but definitely a product of its time. You couldn't get away with an arcade game like this anymore, I don't think. Too much violence and gore is fine. That's nothing to worry about. But it's the parents would moan, oh, it's intentionally making my child spend all this money. And it's being unfair, because everything's got to be fair and above board nowadays, doesn't it? But I digress. That is Alien VP. AVP. And what a game it is. It's still fantastic. So, yeah. What's next? What is next? Is there going to be a next? Or do I end it there? Do I end? Do I continue? Is there anything in particular I fancy playing? Let me see. I'm just flicking through some of the stuff that I've grabbed recently and wanted to highlight on a video at some point. You know what? I haven't played enough Amiga on this channel, and I'm disgusted with myself. So I'm going to play some Amiga. I know that for sure. And I've got just the ticket. I mean, it is Christmas after all. So Christmas is Christmas. And it can't be Christmas unless you play something Christmassy. So, over here on the Amiga side of things, let me just get it set up. It might take me a few seconds just to get everything ready. But over here on the Amiga side, we'll close down MAME. We'll get the Amiga emulator up. And we'll put it in CD32 mode. Yes. Yes, CD32. You know why? For a cracker. What a cracker. I'm just going to adjust the visuals somewhat. Because, WinUAE doesn't always like my setup too much. So, I'm going to just adjust it slightly. There we go. It's Christmas. Christmas game's got to be done. Even if it is just one. Right, I just got to get the controls working. So, Xbox One controller for Windows. What are the buttons? No. Okay, it's not going to like my controller for Windows, so I'm going to go with a keyboard layout and just play it with keyboard. So this is a Christmas disc. And it's got a whole host of Christmassy festive games for the Amiga. Demos, back when you could play demos of games that were completely different from the final release just for Christmas, just to give you a few levels of something cool. And as you can see, this disc is packed. You can have a look at Maria's box at Christmas. We're not going to do that. We are going to play Psycho Santa. Now, this game is very little known, actually. It's kind of fun. It's very simple, but it is a lot of fun. And it's made by the guys who made Syndicate, of all games. This game was made by the dudes who did Syndicate, and Theme Park, and Theme Hospital, and Fusion, and Black and White. Yes, Bullfrog were, as you can see right there, Bullfrog made this game. And it was a Christmas special. It was dumped on the front of a cover disc for a magazine, just as a freebie. And here's the music again. Listen to that Amiga mod work its magic. Classic system. So the idea is to make the houses happy, and you do that by throwing snow at them. Yeah, it's easier said than done, because you have to just get in the right spot to make the snowball drop. And I am not in the right spot. There we go, you see the toys dropping? So the idea is to drop the toys. Each time you do, the house gets a bit more Christmassy. Until you run out of toys, and then you have to destroy enemies. And dodge death. Ah, I died. Oh no. Playing this with keyboard's quite tricky.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's Christmassy. Hey, the lights are on and Santa's flying. Prepare for the bonus level. Now this is where it gets tough. You gotta press the button at the right time to make Santa jump. If you get the timing wrong, he slows down. The idea is to get to the right height to get every present on the tree. And it's easier said than done. Ah! My timing is totally off. Yeah. There's no way I'm getting this. Nah, no chance. Not even close. Right, so let's make these houses Christmassy. Let's drop stuff on them. Oh, I'm missing. Ah, come on. No, I'm out of presents. I've got to go up and face death. That's not creepy, not in the slightest. Now where's my snowy house? Right, there's one. Oh, my health is going to shit. Let's get some more toys. Ah! I missed all of them. Is that the only toy I picked up? Shit. I'm nearly dead. Get it. No! Son of a bitch. This time, surely. There we go. There we go. We got some presents. Alright. Oh no, the houses are losing their Christmas faith. No, I ran out of time. Oh no. This game is hard. Especially on keyboard. Let's try it one more time. Right, this one looks fairly Christmassy. Let's get going with this one. No? It's just getting that rhythm and timing down. It's very tricky. Oh no! Whoa! 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 Whoa. Give me that present. Let's take this one out. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Get the timing right. Yes, we got it. Okay. No, I missed it. Oh, the springing is very precise. You've got to press it just before you actually touch the ground. And as you get higher and higher up, it becomes more and more difficult to be that precise. And there's no kind of audio cue to tell you when it's coming up. You just see a flicker of snow, a pixel of snow, and you go for it. Because by the time you've pressed the button, you're hitting that deck pretty quick. Come on. No. No good. Okay. That's one house done. Much easier than last time, although we do need a refill by about now. No, he's coming backwards. Is that going to be enough? Not if I miss like that, it's not going to be. And I'm dead. Oh no. Well, that was Psycho Santa. Let's see what else this Christmas disc has to offer. Merry Christmas from Amiga J, whoever he may be. It's time for a few more M&Ms. Bonk. So we should be kicking in about now. What's going on? It's just spinning, doing nothing. There we go. So many different Christmas games. It's gotta be ATR. Last game of the night. I love this racing game. It got really poor reviews in the magazines, but it's actually fantastic. It's done by Team 17, the guys who did Worms. This is a demo that's designed purely to celebrate Christmas. Here we go. And I love this game. And this Christmas theme is just great. In fact, I probably need to turn up the volume. So I'll do that when I get a chance. Ding 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 ding. Ah, going the wrong way. Bouncing over shit, going round shit, steering us real hard, crashing into Christmas trees. Can't think of lyrics, it's 1:40, I can't think of much. I'm real fucking tired, that's why this is gonna be the last game I play. But it is a good one. I really love this ATR, even though the magazine said it was shit. Yeah, you finished the race, and now we can bask in the glory that is the intro music. So let's do another race. Same course. There are a few other courses for the demo, but this is the Christmas course, so we're playing it again. And we're going to come first. Pardon me, I may have been drinking earlier, so excusing me. I've been drinking at Christmas, after the kids went sleeping. I had a couple of cans of brewski and some whiskey. Now we're having happy days, driving around on a Mickey game. Woo! I'm not gonna come first, am I? Fuck sticks. Lap 4. Yeah, eat my first place. Eat it, suck it down, chew it. Say, oh, that was delightful, thank you for cooking it for me. And then shove me in second. Ugh. Pipped at the post. Oh well. Curse you, Ben! So let's do another race course. Oh, they're not available in the demo. Okay, well, I was going to do another race course, but the game won't let me. And on that note, I'm getting a bit sleepy. I'm getting a bit tired. And my throat is getting a bit creaky. So, yeah, still not well, unfortunately. Hence why there was no Christmas special video, no New Year's special video. I'm going to try to do a best of games for 2016 video over the next couple of days. So hopefully the throat will hold out to enable me to do that. Yeah. And until then, and if I can't make it, I hope you have a wonderful Christmas, if it hasn't ended for you already. And if it has, then I hope you have a wonderful New Year. And I'll see you in 2017, unless you're George Michael. And then rest in peace, Billy. Okay. Anyway, I'm going. Sleepy. Good night.